for its use of PPPs in delivering healthcare, that it has a capacity issue, and therefore this case was extremely inconvenient and embarrassing for it, because not only because it was a bad case and bad publicity for people, but it was also bad publicity for the very policy that they were being praised by the WHO and others for. That was the issue, and that's why they pushed back, I think, because they don't, they don't want to admit that PPP isn't a magic bullet, or that PPP without really strong oversight and monitoring is as dangerous as inadequate capacity of state delivery.
I have another question. You may be think that I got to know this. You have also read Subhajit Banerjee's report, and also after that you have been there, and you know that the government guidebook says that it should be in government health facility centers, which are sort of fully equipped, or otherwise it should be a private static unit, which also has the fully equipped thing. So when government gives this type of subcontract to NGO, despite in the guidebook it is not there, it has been come through a subsequent, a GO or like that. So don't you think that government is actually trying to give some kind of incentive so those people who has got nothing to do with medical specialization or like that?
Yes.
And it is a kind of, coming back or returning there to what is supposed to be their duty to fight, because it is the government hospital anyway have to be engaged there.
Sure. No, but I mean, I think I'm just looking for the name. One of the, amongst the evidence that the SSP collected was some CDs of previous camps conducted by the NGO, whose name I can't quite remember, JMO Welfare Society. Yeah, they were clearly showed that this NGO was basically defrauding people, in the sense that the same woman would appear holding a blackboard, with the date of her mini lap operation, in different places, and so they were using this video and stuff to basically double claim on everything they were doing. So not only were they doing a thoroughly discreditable and bad job of the procedures, they were also recording the program and there was, Subhajit told me, I'm not sure what the laws of slander in this country are, so I need to be careful, but there was some link, I'll put a more detail than that, between some of the NGOs that had, I didn't write this because I couldn't prove it, but he said that there was evidence of links between some of the NGOs who had approval to carry out these family welfare camps, and senior BR politicians. So there was a bit of a feedback. It was a good business going until this blew it out of the water.
And I think, I as far as I remember, the civil surgeon of RRA told that he has done, that organization has done very good job in the past and had done 6,000 operations previously. But the government, whereas the government of Bihar, Araria district government hospitals could not do 6,000 at all. So the only one organization could do 6,000 in a 2 years' time, whereas government couldn't give even half of it.
Yeah. I mean, either they're lying or they were doing it on such an industrial scale that you really have to wonder just how awful. Kappa Forum may not be any worse, kind of the worst of the sorts of things that they were doing, and mass sterilisation camps done in very basic conditions at high speed. I'm sure that's the thing what they were like. Not only were they probably did do that, but they were also defrauding the system. So I think that
No, I wanted to do another two, three things, just like, don't you think that this is a gross human violation, human rights violation?